Hi there, Doug Stuman with IT Creations with one of Dell's workhorse server platforms, the Dell PowerEdge R770 server. This is a 2U system that features loads of options to support a number of diverse workloads and storage configurations. Not to be confused with the Dell PowerEdge R770 CSP edition, which is a purpose-built platform optimized for cloud service providers, or CSPs, and high-density scale-out workloads. Both are outfitted with dual Intel Xeon 6 processors with P-cores or E-cores. However, this platform offers more configuration options to support your business with more memory, storage, plus support for up to 7 single-width GPUs or 2 double-width GPUs. Let's take a look. The Dell PowerEdge R770 is designed to support virtualization, artificial intelligence inferencing, cloud-native applications, hyperscale workloads, and scale-out database, to name a few. Dell says this system offers 1.69 times the performance per watt than the previous model, given the improved power efficiency and rack density. Whereas the CSP version is limited to specific configurations, including processors, memory, and storage, it makes it easy to scale out and to integrate with your existing infrastructure. I believe our non-CSP version to be highly scalable and also offers much more versatility. Our platform can support up to 32 E3.S EDSFF SSD drive bays using 4 of a potential 5 drive partitions on the front of the system, each of which can house 8 E3.S drives. This system can also be ordered with 40 EDSFF drives with all of those 5 partitions loaded with drive cages, 16 using just 2, or 8 E3.S bays with just 1 of the partitions. Also supported are configurations with 2.5-inch drive bays, including 8, 16, and 24-bay options, supporting SAS, SATA, and NVMe. Additionally, an 8-bay with a universal backplane. Also a 16-bay 2.5-inch version that can be outfitted with SAS and SATA drive types only. The rear of the chassis can also be outfitted with more storage in the form of a 4-bay EDSF drive carrier for Gen 5 NVMe drives for up to 44 E3.S drives. But we'll get to that. Are you interested in the Dell PowerEdge R770 server? If you are, then for a limited time, you can save up to $500 off the purchase of a system that's listed or one that you can configure at IT Creations that's valued at $5,000 or more. Just click that link for more information, and when you're ready to make a purchase, just mention this video. Use the keyword Open Sesame. I'm kidding, no keywords required. This platform offers I/O in the front or in the rear of the chassis, depending on your needs for access to the cold aisle or hot aisle. This mullet can be worn either way. You know, business in the front and party in the back.
It's like a mullet. Business in the front, party in the back.
Maybe that wasn't the best analogy. Anyways, our platform has 32 E3.S drives in front with the central bay empty and fitted with a blank perforated panel for airflow. That said, there is a front I/O version with 8 EDSFF bays and a 16 EDSFF bay version that takes up just 1 or 2 storage cages in the middle respectively. There is an optional security bezel for the front, but not for the front I/O version. Depending on whether you have the I/O slots on the front or rear of the system, you get different ports. With a front I/O, the ports are divided between the left and right server ears with storage in the middle and PCI slots to either side. The left server ear has the secondary control panel with one USB 2.0 Type-C port and a mini display port, which is optional. Also optional is a KVM module. On the right is the primary control panel, which has a power on button, Type-C USB 2.0 port. Also optional are 2 ports on the left, an optional serial COM port, and then on the right, an optional dedicated iDRAC port, which is part of Riser 4. That left OCP slot on the bottom can also be outfitted with an optional boot optimized storage subsystem or BOS to boot the system using 1 or 2 M.2 drives. Another option with no OCP slots along the bottom. At the back of the system, there are dual power supply units to either side of the chassis on the bottom. That's about it as far as anything that might be consistent. Like the front, there are a whole lot of options. PCI slots along the top with several OCP sized slots below. The one on the right for an I/O panel with a VGA port, 2 USB 3.0 ports, a dedicated iDRAC port for remote management, and then a system identification button LED. The other slot right beside it can be used for an optional BOS N1 DC MHS card. That last bit stands for Data Center Modular Hardware System. Yes, that indicates it's designed for data center environments, which I never thought was in question, but here we are. The other OCP slot on our system is outfitted with a quad port SFP28 mezzanine card offering 25 gigabit Ethernet. That BOS controller is designed to boot the server's operating system and can be outfitted with a single NVMe M.2 drive or two. For a single drive, RAID 0, and with dual drives, a RAID 1 configuration. The system can be outfitted with a 4-bay EDSFF drive carrier, but that will take out a few PCI slots. At this point, maybe I should add that this platform can support up to 4 OCP mezzanine card slots for network communications. That said, I'm just going to have you take a look at the potential expansion options available on the system, because we could be here for quite a while if I attempt to run through all of them. If this platform is configured with processor liquid cooling modules, you will also lose a few PCI slots to the inlet-outlet tubes. Let's crack this nut open, but before we do that, a little bit on management. Management of the system is provided through the integrated Dell Remote Access Controller port, front or back, depending on the I/O condition. Alongside the release of these 17th generation servers, Dell also released iDRAC 10 in August or September of this year. With iDRAC 10, you can manage this server remotely through an intuitive browser-based user interface. It can also be integrated with the rest of your infrastructure through Dell's OpenManage portfolio, offering end-to-end management of servers, switches, and storage through an intuitive browser interface. With advanced licenses, you can get even more functionality. The system is also compatible with QuickSync 2, enabling administrators to use a smartphone or tablet with the OpenManage mobile app for at-chassis management of the system. If this platform is configured with front I/O, it would have a very different look inside compared with what we do have with 32 EDSFF drive bays up front and I/O in the back. With our 32 drive bays configuration, 4 of the 5 partitions have their own EDSFF backplane module. I'll be honest, I have not seen one of those modules before. Behind those, there are 6 hot swap cooling fans that can be removed individually, or you can remove all 6 fans by releasing the latches to either side of the fan cage bracket. That is not a hot swap operation and will require shutting down the server before removal. Next, we can see the plastic covers for the CPU and memory module slots that feeds that DRAM-scented air directly into the PCI slots to cool those as well. Once removed, you can see the dual sockets for the Intel Xeon 6 CPUs and 32 memory module slots. Depending on the configuration, there are also several heat sinks to choose from, including the option for direct liquid cooling modules. Each of the processors supports an 8-channel memory architecture and is in charge of 16 of those 32 memory module slots for up to 2 DIMMs per channel. At full capacity, up to 8 terabytes of DDR5 registered DIMMs can be installed. If you plan on installing a single memory module, then only a 32 gigabyte memory module per CPU with E-cores or a 16 or 32 gigabyte module for P-core processors. Compatible with the system are Intel Xeon 6700 or 6500 series processors with efficiency cores or E-cores, and those with performance cores or P-cores, but you can't mix. CPUs are limited to a thermal design power threshold of 350 watts. They can provide up to 86 P-cores or up to 144 E-cores per socket, depending on your needs for performance or efficiency. For high-performance workloads like AI, HPC, and things like that, P-cores. For high-density scale-out, power efficiency, and high single-threaded core density, E-cores. Those with P-cores also feature Intel hyper-threading technology, effectively doubling the core count to up to 172 virtual threads on those high-end CPUs. E-cores do not support Intel hyper-threading, so only 144 virtual threads. The system also offers CXL memory expansion support. Using the CXL interconnect devices, administrators can augment the system with cache coherent memory expansion to expand the server's memory capacity beyond that which can be installed just using the memory module slots. There are various form factors for these CXL devices, including an E3.S form factor. That said, Dell's documentation supports something that connects directly to one of the CXL-enabled riser slots. Unfortunately, there's not much information available for this specific feature at this time, so I'll leave it at that. Moving to the back, there are 3 risers visible, risers 1, 3, and 5. Risers 1 and 3 can be used for GPU support. Underneath those are risers 2 and 4. There are a lot more options for risers 2 depending on your workload needs. Several storage controllers can be installed too, with options for front-mounted controllers plus those that fit in back, including a host bus adapter. For this system, you have a choice of direct-attached NVMe drives, or you can install up to 2 storage controllers for hardware RAID support. This system can be outfitted with either 2 double-wide 350-watt GPUs or up to 6 single-wide 75-watt GPUs. With the 75-watt GPUs, no additional power cables are needed, as the PCI slot delivers 75 watts of power. That is definitely not the end of it, and there are quite a few more options I didn't even touch upon, but I think you get the picture. The Dell PowerEdge R770 has a lot of options, period. I hope you liked this short review. But if you do have questions on this platform or maybe something else, then leave a comment in the section below. I also placed a few links in the description area for more information on this system, or you can use that one right there, itcreations.com. Until next time, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations, and thanks for watching.